So, in general, there's very little research on stereotype threat self-objectification concerning women in sports. There's a little bit concerning African Americans and biases and stereotypes there. So this is some of the first research in this area. First, gender stereotypes in league golf. Just give you a flavor of some of the things that we're doing as an example. This is a 2x2 design where we randomly assigned female participants to a condition where they played Nintendo Wii and they played with a male or female avatar. And Nintendo Wii is, I think, provides us a unique opportunity to allow participants to put themselves in another body in the way that we used to use role playing or guided imagery for in the past, and we can actually do this with gender with different avatars. So people were randomly assigned to a male or female avatar to prime gender, and then they were told that there are either stereotype, in the stereotype condition, they were told that there were gender differences in performance and that men outperform women, or they were told that there were no gender differences. And then we looked at the effect of both behaviors and attitude. We looked at performance on the golf task itself, how many strokes for 9 holes of golf. And we also looked at self-reported attitudes and physical self-perceptions. And this is some of the results for the performance. And this is strokes taken over 9 holes of golf. So you can see the male avatar in the blue. Participants being told that stereotypes do in fact exist, perform the best. So again, everything else is exactly the same, except if you play with a male avatar and told men actually perform better, you will perform better. This is known in the literature as stereotype lift rather than stereotype threat. And it's not just performance. But some of the other things that we found on the AIMS, the Athletic Identity Measurement Scale, and the Physical Self-Perception. What was doing the priming. So our next step is actually to use an androgynous avatar, tell people in one condition it's male, and the other condition female, and hopefully we'll control it.
My question was about your slide where the women are dressed in different clothing. If I remember correctly, the one shows the women in concealed clothing actually had the most cuts. As opposed to the women in the revealing clothing.
In the stereotype threat design, it was number of strokes taken over 9 holes, and in the self-objectification, it was number of made putts until you missed a total of 5 times. So actually, in golf, lower scores are better, but the way that we set up our mini putt was the number of made putts until you missed 5 times. So better scores, higher scores are better. Sorry about that.
I thought something that was really fascinating was how opposite your results in terms of the revealing clothing were to the comments of that FIFA president, yeah. Right? So we're going to put women into revealing tight clothes and in that way make them worse athletes,
yeah.
Right? So it just a comment to underline that really interesting finding and just with your example and your actual research.
Yes, thank you for that. I don't think Seth Blatter was really too interested in women's performance. I think he is worth